Allah is calling you. Allah is calling you.
Calling you.
Calling you to say his name. Allah is calling you. Calling you to come home again. Allah is calling you. His mercy far exceeds his wrath. He wants that you stay on the path.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And welcome to a new episode of your show, De-Stress, the show where we try and introduce new Islamic meanings which help you to de-stress and take away anxiety and to live a happy life in this dun, in this life and the next life, inshallah. What we will be focusing on today is zuhd, which is leaving the dunya and putting aside and knowing the true measurement of this dunya. And we will talk about that and how that reflects stress, because there's a famous saying which says that anxiety is based on expectations. What you expect and the way that you expect things when they don't happen the way you feel, that's when you feel that you're stressed out. But if you have low expectations or you know things and you put them in true perspective, that's when you're not let down and you're not stressed out. And this dunya, the Prophet ﷺ describes it, that it's not even worth the wing of a fly to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The wing of the fly, you can imagine how small that is. It's a transparent, tiny thing. The dunya is not even like that. The Prophet ﷺ, he says, رَقْعَتَيْ الْفَجْ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. The two sunnah raq'at that you do before fajr are better than the whole dunya and everything that it encompasses. This is the true value of the dunya. The Prophet ﷺ, when he describes the dunya, he says that it is exactly like if you come into a big ocean and you put your finger in that ocean and you pull it out. What will you come out with that? You'll find nothing. These tiny, tiny droplets, if anything, which evaporate, this is the value of the dunya. Our problem is that we're over-glorifying the dunya. We're making it seem much bigger than it actually is. The dunya is nothing. It's a phase which goes by. The Prophet ﷺ, when he describes his relationship to al-dunya, he says that he is like a traveler. This traveler comes by and he sits next to a tree. And then when he leaves everything with it. Imagine you're traveling a long travel and you have all your stuff with you, and then you stop to rest for a couple of minutes. What will you buy? What will you leave there? This is the difference between what we're dealing with the dunya and how the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, used to deal with the dunya. For them, the dunya was just a phase. They realized that this dunya is just a transition. It's a place where you can acquire hasanat, good deeds, so that you get a higher esteem and a higher position in al-Jannah. Al-Imam al-Ghazali, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him, has a beautiful example of the dunya. He talks about the dunya in a very, very nice way. He talks about a man who is in a jungle. This man, suddenly a lion comes up. So this man is running from the lion. He's looking behind him from the lion. He's running. And then suddenly as he's running, he falls off a cliff. And he's falling down. Suddenly he finds a rope and he hangs on to the rope. As he hangs on the rope, he can look up. He sees the lion. And then he looks down and he sees a serpent, a large serpent, opening its mouth, waiting for him to fall so that it can eat him up. So now he looks up, he can see the lion and the serpents at the bottom, and suddenly he sees something holding onto the rope. There are two mice, a black mouse and a white mouse, and both of them are nibbling on the rope. So now he's looking up, he sees the lion, he looks down, he sees the serpent, and he sees the two mice nibbling on the rope, and they're going to get the rope is going to get cut. And when all of this is happening, he looks to his side and he sees a beehive. There are no bees in this beehive, but you can see the beautiful golden honey in it. So he puts out his hand and he takes a dip from the honey and he tastes it in his mouth. As he's doing this, because of the beauty of the honey, he forgets all that he's in. And Imam al-Ghazali, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him, he says, this is your example with the dunya. The lion, which is death, is always running after you and it's always waiting for you. And the rope is your life. And the two mice that are nibbling on it are the night and the day. The black one is the night and the white one is the day. And the serpent that's waiting for you is your grave. If it is good, then you will have good. If it is bad, then it will be bad. And all of this and the dunya is the honey. You tasted the honey, and even though it's very insignificant with the situation that you're in, you're between two deaths. You're between the lion eating you and the serpent gobbling you up, and you're sure that you're going to fall because the mice are there, and you forget all about this, and you're busy with something which is very superficial as the taste of the honey. And this is our example of the dunya. We feel that we get وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. This dunya is a temptation. It's something which keeps you astray from the true meaning of your life. Your life is الْآخِرَةُ. When people are asked on the Day of Judgment about their life, how long they've lived, these are people who might have lived 60, 70, maybe 100 years. They will say, we have lived only a day or part of a day. This is the truth of this life. This life is something but just a momentary bliss. It's very passing by. It's very quick to pass. It's a fitna, as it's described in many ahadith and in the Quran, that this is a temptation, is something which leads you astray. What we need to realize that this dunya is exactly that. It's a test. It's a dunya. Dunya coming from dunu, coming from lower. This is the lower, because al-akhirah is the higher. This is where you get elevated. The true winners, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارُ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازِ. The one that's passed or moved away from Jahannam, from hellfire, and moved into Jannah, he is the true winner. It doesn't really matter how much blessings you've had in this dunya, how much money you've had, how much the Prophet ﷺ, when he describes in the hadith, he says that the true richness is not richness of property, but it's richness of having content, having a contentment, having being happy that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His blessings. وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will never encompass them. This is the meaning that we should live with. We should remember that this dunya is something that passes by very quickly and is very momentary. But we should thrive for al-akhirah, which is always, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes al-akhirah, هي الحيوان. This is the true life. The only life is the life of al-akhirah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would say, اللهم لا عيش إلا عيش الآخرة. There is no life but the life of the hereafter. Because this life is not a life. This is a phase where you are partially alive. You become alive fully and eternally when you get into al-akhirah. But when we're talking about this, so that people don't get misunderstand what we're saying, is that that doesn't mean that you don't own anything. You can own things, you can count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But as Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with him, described perfectly, detachment from this dunya does not mean detachment from having things, or owning things. It means that nothing owns you. And this is the meaning that we have to live by, that we live for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, say that my life and my death and my sacrifice and my prayers are to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ. There is no, I do not associate any partners with him. And this is how our life should be. And this is how we should relieve our stress. We should know that this dunya is just a phase, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this as a test. We're not here to, if you don't have lots of money, it doesn't matter. As long as you have a big house in al-Jannah. If you don't have, if you've got a bit of sickness, illness, but in the akhirah you're fine and you're in the highest levels of Jannah, this is the true winner. This is the true meaning of happiness. Our problem is that we're so attached with the dunya that when we lose something, even if it's something small, or we get a calamity here or there, then we feel, why is this happening to us? Because we're attached to it, we feel that this is our only chance to be happy, when we should realize that the true happiness is in al-akhirah. Allahumma la aisha illa aisha al-akhirah. There is no life but the life of al-akhirah. And this is why when we get the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he talks about the least person in Jannah. This is the last person coming into Jannah. He will get the same as this world, one of the kings of this world, the biggest king in the world, the one that has the biggest mansions, the biggest armies, the biggest everything. The last person to enter Jannah, the one that has the least in Jannah, will have 10 times as much as this person. Imagine 10 times as much as the biggest king. Not only that, but you will have the malaika, the angels will come and serve you. You will have your friends there. You will see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You will get to see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this dunya is really not worth the fight. It's not really worth the stress. You need to realize that this dunya is nothing. This dunya is a momentary phase, something that will pass by quickly. And so when you realize that, you realize that الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. The people who are, when they're tested with a calamity, they say, إِنَّ اللَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَجْعُونَ, which means that we come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to Him we will return. When you realize the meaning that you come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you realize that nothing really here is yours. This is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to you as a test, has given to you so that you can borrow it, even your life. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he talks about the grave, he says that when you go to the grave, three things will follow you. Your money will follow you, or your wealth will follow you, your family will follow you, and your deeds will follow you. But when you're put in the grave, only two things will leave, and one stays. Your family will leave, your wealth will leave, and your deeds stay. This is what we need to realize. We need to realize that the true life is the life of al-akhirah. If we have all the wealth in the world, and the biggest and most prestigious family in the world, and we have no deeds, then when we come to die, we will have nothing. And this dunya is a phase which goes, but the al-akhirah, the hereafter, is infinite. So no matter how much enjoyment you have in this dunya, if you are deprived in al-akhirah, in the hereafter, then you are truly lost everything. And that's why this is the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when He says, فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ فَقَدْ فَازِ. This is the true winner, the one that he enters Jannah. This is the one who has won, this is the one who has achieved the highest and ultimate goal in his life, to get into Jannah, so that he can meet the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with him. This is our target, this is what we should be thriving for, and we need to realize that this dunya is nothing. It's not even, as the Prophet ﷺ said, it's nothing, it's not even worth the wing of a fly. Not even one whole fly, this is the wing of a fly. And we're fighting over it, and we're killing each other, and we're backbiting, and we're swearing, and we're doing all of these things for nothing. And as Ali ibn Talib perfectly said, that the dunya owns us. And this is why when we make dua, we say, Allahumma la taj'al ad-dunya akbar hammina. Do not make this dunya our biggest concern. Because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, whoever has the dunya as his main concern, poverty will be between his eyes, and he will never be satisfied with it, and he will get nothing extra except what has been decreed for him. And whoever makes al-akhirah his goal and his ultimate place, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make him rich, he will make him happy, his heart will be content, he will feel joy of believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us realize that how puny this dunya is and how big al-akhirah is, and make us thrive to it, and to raise our level in Jannah, and to bless us with His love and the love of the people who love Him. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us al-Jannah and to take the dunya out of our hearts and to keep it in our hands. And hopefully I'll see you next episode inshallah of your show, Distress. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Allah is calling you. Allah is calling you.
Calling you.
Calling you to say His name. Allah is calling you. Calling you to come home again. Allah is calling you. Calling you to say His name. Allah is calling you. Calling you to come home again. Allah is calling you. His mercy far exceeds His wrath. He wants that you stay on the path.